In the Caribbean, most homes are constructed using concrete, clay, and cement. One reason for this would be the climate is cool and there's no need for insulation, as is needed in temperate countries. As an aesthetic, different styles and shapes of blocks, columns, and even plant potters are made of cement, ensuring long life and durability for the Caribbean home. Just minutes from the Endeavour flyover in Chaguanas is Raja's Pottery Shop. This 10-man pottery operation has over 8 years of experience in crafting columns and many other items from scratch, with dozens of finished items being produced each day. The production process starts with the delivery of cement to the factory in bulk. The other raw material used is red sand. This is used in the mold-making process for the columns and bases. These items are truly handmade. At the start of the production process, red sand is shoveled into a bucket mold and compressed with a weighted hand tool by a factory worker. This compacted mold of sand is then loaded onto a special potter's wheel to begin the process of making the base of a column. The wheel is fitted with a special shaping tool known as a jig, used to cut the pattern for the base into the mold of the red sand. As the wheel turns, a small wooden strip is used to measure the height of the mold and is matched against the edge of the jig to ensure that all the column bases are made to the same exacting height. After shaping the red sand into the basic shape, an artisan starts by adding a light cement and water mixture to the shaped red sand mold, preparing it for the next stage. Once this is done, a more viscous cement mixture is skillfully added to the mold while it spins on the potter's wheel. This heavy cement mixture then needs to be shaped once again into the pattern required for the base. Skillfully using this tool, the artisan reintroduces the pattern and the column base begins to take shape. After the final touches are made and the design of the column is smooth and even, a pattern is pressed into the wet cement. The finished base is then moved to a designated area to be dried at room temperature over a 24-hour period. At the end of the drying period, the bases are then cleaned of the red sand and the concrete mold is left hollowed out and ready for use as a base of a concrete column. Other items made at this pottery plant include concrete medallions. These are made by first using a fiberglass master to form a mold. This mold is made using special fiberglass fabric and resin. The material is pasted onto a finished piece and allowed to dry at room temperature for 24 hours. The fiberglass fabric then hardens and takes the shape of the original piece, forming a negative. These negatives are then used as a new mold for fresh concrete to be poured into, thereby forming a new piece of pure concrete. The same procedure is used in the making of balusters. These are short pillars or columns that are traditionally used in support railings. As before, the fiberglass mold plays an important part in the manufacture of these concrete balusters. At the start, the fiberglass molds are treated in a chemical bath of resins, wax, alum oxides, and other additives. This prevents the balusters from sticking to the inside of the mold during the curing process. The molds are then clasped together and the cement mixture is then added into a small opening at the top. Here we see open molds being filled with the cement mixture to form a decorative baluster on one side and a flat surface on the other. At the end of the 24-hour drying process, the molds are then opened and the shaped concrete balusters are revealed. A light sanding, and these are ready for the next construction job. These columns are formed the very same way, using the mold process. Spot the difference though? The molds are fitted with a pipe to create a hollowed center for the column. This is necessary as the columns will be installed as supports for roofing or other uses that will require them to withstand weight. The hollowed center will be filled with more cement when installing at the construction site. Giant plant potters like this one are also made using these fiberglass molds. With lots of different shapes, designs, and uses for these items, there will always be a need for concrete columns, pillars, and balusters. And rather than import it, now you know how we make it.